I don't know what it is lately, but I have just been feeling like complete crap. I feel weak. I feel exhausted. And like I said, there's no reason why I should be feeling this way. I took the last 5 days off from working out. Two or three of those might have been because I was playing Fallout, but when I realized on Friday that I was spending too much time playing Fallout, I was like, I can't play this game anymore. And it wasn't really a tough decision for me to make, but it's just like, I realized that it was taking my time away from me, and I wanted to play the game, I'm not gonna lie, and I still want to. I'm not by any means much of a gamer, but just a hot hype with the TV show, and I started watching the TV show actually. It's been pretty good so far. I think I have like two or three episodes left, and I just wanted to play the game again, you know, make my own little settlements, get all the missions out of the way. But I realized that I was taking too much time away from working out that I was just like, I can't play this game. So one of the side effects that people don't really talk about when they're taking extra supplements is the estrogen imbalance that you may or may not have in your body. Like, sure, people may talk about it in the sense of gynecomastia. I don't think I pronounced that word correctly. But it's just, that's not the only thing that can happen. Like, sure, it could be a little bit more emotional, more in touch with your feelings. And actually, that's how I'm feeling right now. I think that's why I'm feeling pretty weak. You know, so I think I need to, actually, I was supposed to take a shot today along with a pill that helps prevent or stop the conversion to estrogen. So that's probably why I'm feeling pretty down today. Didn't take a shot and the pill. So I have to do that tonight, you know, for sure, 100%. Because right now I'm here, I'm chilling, having a good workout, but I'm also listening to like sad love music right now, like country music, which I actually truly enjoy it. But I'm just like, there's no reason for me to be in my feelings right now, you know? Because things are great in my life right now. Not 100% the most amazing, you know, I do have some work-related issues. But nothing that's really like, man, why am I listening to love songs right now? You know, like breakup love songs that make you miss somebody. Which isn't, you know, the worst when you're in a relationship, which I am. You know, it just makes you care for your partner even more. But I'm like, I gotta be in the zone. I gotta make sure this workout is 100% intense and overloaded. Like, the preacher curls that I did over there, I don't know why, but I think I might need to switch back to my old program, man. The fact that I took the last like 5 days off from working out, nothing's helping. I'm not doing myself any favors. So, and I still haven't like fixed this program to really tailor it for myself, which is why I'm thinking I gotta switch back to my old program. You know, it's just. I also think all this like bloating, me getting fat, like I'm probably pushing like 250 right now. Maybe not 250, but probably 240. I haven't weighed myself in a while, and I was just like, I feel like I'm getting fatter. And I want to buy a new desk treadmill, but I also want to wait because I'm moving in 2 weeks, like I said. and I want to continue walking the treadmill, but I don't want to ship it to my current place and then have to move it, you know? So I'd rather just kind of hold off another 2 weeks on that aspect and then get it. Because as soon as I get it, I will be on that for at least 4 to 6 hours a day, just walking. Like, I will get tired, my feet will get tired from just standing and walking for sure. But I will at least be on the treadmill 4 to 6 hours a day. And I think that's why my last one broke. It's just, it was constantly on all the time. And it lasted a year, which I think was pretty good for the amount that I used it for. And I don't think these treadmills are meant to be walked on that long, for that long of a duration, in just one day. Like, I lubricated, probably over-lubricated, to be honest. But they're not like the gym treadmills, the commercial treadmills. They're just like treadmills for some simple walking. And so I think that's why mine broke. These RDLs feel fucking heavier than normal. I'm gonna go heavier, but man, and I think that's another side effect of just having estrogen in general. Why women are weaker is because they have a higher estrogen, right? Higher estrogen levels. And the more estrogen somebody has, typically the weaker they get. So I think I have too much estrogen in my body. That's just personal opinion. Also, I've been training, I don't really know. It's just my reasoning as to why this is happening today. I think I need to back off from the amount that I'm taking and just kind of go back to a TRT level. Like, I'm not taking that much, at least in my personal opinion. But I think I need to go back to a TRT level. And I also think that my blood work is coming up in the next like month or so. So it's probably a good idea for me to back off. Lately, it's been impossible for me to stand up from a squat. Ugh. My buddy here, Demetrius, last time I talked to him, which was almost a week ago now, I think it was like last Wednesday, might have been last Tuesday to be honest, the last time I was here at the gym, he told me that I should ice my elbow for about 15, 20 minutes or so. I think that's what he said. He either said ice it or warm it, or heat it up with the heating pad. I think heating pad was heat it up anytime throughout the night, but as soon as I'm done working out, I should ice it. And the only reason I'm thinking about this now, and I'm talking about it the day I saw him when I was here, is because my elbow wasn't hurting. And now I'm actually feeling some pain today. So I'm about to do that tonight, ice it. But the thing is, my drive home is like 20 minutes, not counting if I have to go to the store, which I do have to tonight. He also told me that Meijer is open till midnight. And it is almost 10. Walmart closes at 11, so I have like some extra time to go to the store and pick up groceries. Now, I'm not sure how I personally feel about Meijer. Kroger though, here's my beef with Kroger. Anytime I go to a different location of Kroger, everything is in a different place. It could either be like reverse, but still like differently. Like when I go to Walmart, I have a general idea of where I'm at because they look very, very similar to one another. Whether it's a superstore or a regular store, like it's really very similar. Kroger though, there's no consistency with the Krogers that I've been to, none. I'm sure like there is maybe from a few to a few, like there's like probably 3 to 5 different types of consistencies that I've seen when I go to Kroger, but man, Walmart has down to two different variations from the Walmarts that I've been to. And that's my personal experience, so Meijer, I've only been to like one, maybe two different Meijers, but like I don't normally go to Meijer, so like I've been going to one Meijer recently, just because I have to. But so far, I have no issue with Meijer. You know, there's no. We're gonna find out today. Hopefully, they are open till midnight, which I'm pretty sure they are. I mean, Demetrius said they are. He goes. He works out at the gym here around the same time I do, and has to go grocery shopping after the gym like I do. So he probably knows. He's right. So Demetrius, if you're watching this, thank you. Gotta pick up some milk. And probably in a pack of ice as soon as I get out of there to cool down my elbow. You know, the rear delts, even though they're a small muscle group and probably get taxed very easily, I feel like I just rep these out, rest like 30 seconds, maybe a little bit more, and do as many reps as I did the first time. You know, basically doing drop sets here or rest pauses. But I don't know. Also, the elbow pain that I have, it's honestly different than what I was feeling before. I think I definitely I relieved a lot of the pain with the lacrosse ball that I did like 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. I haven't done it since the one time I did it, but I think that helped out tremendously. But now the pain is like different, in a different spot, which is why I'm like, all right, Demetrius has to do this, which is what I'm gonna do tonight. May not be in a video, but I'm gonna try to make the conscious effort to make it happen. I gotta make sure that I start tracking these exercises, like this specific exercise, because like I don't. Like I feel like I could do so many reps of these. I don't know. I'm ready for bed. Like I could honestly just fall asleep right now. Let's actually find out what the last time what I logged last time of this. Nope, not that one. This is actually supposed to be the last exercise for today, but I'm honestly just mixing and matching. I don't do this very often, but once in a while I'm just like, all right, I'm gonna do this now. Just kind of switch it up, just kind of keep it somewhat exciting, because I'm not gonna lie, today I'm pretty bored with today's workout. Like I'm not mentally in it. So for me to be somewhat stimulated to do today's workout, I have to change something up. And I don't want to switch my programming and just do random stuff, which I might do again from time to time. But I would rather just switch up the order of my exercises. All right, the last time I tracked this, I did 70 pounds for 10 reps, 90 for 10, 100 for 10. I just did 100 for I don't know how many reps because I wasn't counting, but I'm going to put that as the first set for today. I'm going to put down that I did 10 reps. I don't know how many I did, but yeah, I did 100. I thought I did 110, but I'm going to do a few more sets of these just because I feel like my rear delts, they definitely need some, what's the word, development. And I don't know, I feel like I can do so many of these, my rear delts will not be as taxed as somebody else's rear delts. I don't know. It's just my personal opinion. You know what? Let's go to 110. Let's try it out. See how many reps I'm able to do with 110. 14 reps. So I'm supposed to be doing this exercise with the straight bar. I think I'm gonna switch it to the rope because I just feel like a better contraction versus the straight bar. Or maybe I'm just like emphasizing different muscle groups in my back. But I feel way better doing it with the rope. I'm not gonna lie, I feel like vomiting. I couldn't be in the gym anymore. I have no idea why I feel like vomiting. It's just, man. The last couple of days, I think my metabolism has honestly like slowed down a lot. Because I used to be very active, mainly because of the jobs that I had. They were very physical jobs, not like, well, I was working at a warehouse at one point. And then before that was a restaurant, so I wasn't really sitting down. Now I have a desk job. And I'm not moving as much. Even when I have the treadmill, I'm still not moving as much. I'm not sweating as much. I think I've put on way too much weight way too quickly because of that. And it sucks. And I think that's what's making me sick, along with probably the slightly elevated levels of estrogen, which honestly, I have no idea that's actually true. I think that's just my personal opinion. But man, I'm just not feeling well. Like I don't feel sick. I'm just like, I kind of feel like vomiting. If that makes any sense. You know, I just want to throw up whatever's in my stomach. Probably feel better. And it's probably a lot of junk food. But whatever. I gotta go home. Actually, I gotta go to the store. What do I need to get? Like, I'm leaving early. Like, I could go to Walmart right now instead of going to Meijer. But I think I'm going to go to Meijer, see where everything's at, get to know the place better, if I'm going to go there more consistently past 11, just so I can quickly get in, get out. Because I know the people that are working there, they want to hurry up and get out, and they probably don't want to do as much work. So I don't want to be that person that's making them stay longer. Because, you know, working at restaurants, people come in last minute. We'd serve them, you know, be polite, but at the same time, it's like, we don't, everybody wants to go home at the end of the day, so, completely get there. So, I want to be familiar with the store, explore, make sure I know where things are at, so that the next time that I go to the Meijer, I'm in and out, you know. So, if you're ever going to a place that's closing, be nice to people that are working there, you know. It's always from a person that used to work at the restaurants, in restaurants. It was always nice to hear. It's like, oh, never mind, you guys are closing. I would just go home, even though there could be like 10 minutes or so. And that personally made me and my team that I was working with at the time want to serve those people more because they understood they didn't want to be a bother, and they were like, oh no, you're not a bother, you know. And not that anybody is bothered because, you know, we're getting paid to do those things. But it's just like, it's nice for people to acknowledge that and be like, hey, it's okay, I understand, I'm going to go. And we wouldn't say, okay, goodbye. We would be like, oh, it's fine, you know, we'll help you out. But it's just like, that affirmation of them knowing makes it better for us to want to help them or serve them with whatever. So, personal experience, it's good admire. It looks like they're doing some remodeling around here, so if I come to this Meijer again, things may not be in the same place as they are today. So let's see. Hopefully they have food, because I'm looking at this little station over there, and there's nothing. My go-to is always ground beef. I think this might be cheaper, I'm not 100% sure. Or might be pretty close. This is 93.7. I need a big one. They don't have any big ones. Okay. All right. Great. Should I just get this one then? No. Damn. all right, well, if I'm ever in a pinch and I can't make it to Walmart, I guess this will do. Money would never be
a factor. Samsung, can you reach out to me?
Meijer wasn't that bad. You know, I actually might prefer it way much better. Like, wait, I'm trying to put this into words. I like it because it is bright and it's just like, it's welcoming, you know? It's, I don't know how to put that into words, but even though they had a lot of construction going on, I think they're moving a lot of stuff around. So wherever I think today, stuff was today, it's probably not going to be there next time I go there, which is fine. You know, it's not the end of the world. They're probably doing that for a reason. Whereas in Kroger, they're not moving anything, you know? And I literally saw them unstocking the shelves. So, or they could be going out of business, one or the other. I don't know which one, but I like it because I went in there and it's just like bright. It is daylight. You know, it's obviously it's nighttime, but it was, you know, when I go into Walmart, it's also bright, but it's also, it's kind of like dim. Like Walmart brightness, 90%. And Meijer was at like 100%. And then when I go to Kroger, it's like dim yellow lighting. It's not bright. And that could just be a personal preference, but so far, I mean, that's a small detail that it made me, like, honestly, like going to Meijer today. I don't know, it's just, it seemed like it was a bright place to be. That's the best way for me to put it. Anyways, I got what I needed. I saw that they had Greek yogurt that I like. I have some here, so I didn't buy any. And, what else do I need? They also had the seasoning packs from Taco Bell that I like to buy and put on my beef. So that's an extra plus already. So why even go to Walmart at this point? You know, I could just spend more time in the gym, do more sets, train harder. And you know what? I just realized I have more energy now than when I left the gym. And at the gym. Maybe that caffeine's finally kicking in. I don't know. But I wish I was still at the gym so I could use this energy that I have now to continue working out. Because honestly, I half-assed this workout. I did, what, 3 exercises today? I did the preacher curls, which I completely bombed at. I did the snatch grip RDLs, which I realized that it was heavy because I was doing my working set as the warm-up. But I went up, you know, heavier by like 5 or 10 extra pounds or so on each side. And then I did the face pulls and the, what Jeff likes to call the, straight bar prayers. I don't know, whatever. I didn't do my full workout. I wasn't into it, you know, but I did something because I know if I don't do something, I will not do anything. And you know, sometimes you just have to go even though you don't want to. And I didn't go for the last 5 days. 3 of those, like I said, is because I was playing Fallout, and then I caught myself like, listen, time is going by so quickly. It's already 10 p.m. I missed the gym. So I gotta avoid playing Fallout for a little while, you know? And I'm honestly not a big person who likes to play video games. I got tired of playing video games back in high school. I think when I first started working, like senior year maybe, junior year of high school, is when I stopped playing video games, or they started to slow down. And then just, I don't know why, it's just, I stopped being entertained. Like, sure, there's a few video games that I like to play that are like, oh, there's a new version of that game? Great, I'm gonna go get it. Like, the Batman Arkham games, those are amazing. Definitely be playing those again if they come out with new ones, for sure. What's another one? Metal Gear Solid, that's a great game. Love that game. I bought Suicide Squad. I play it because, like, it's supposed to be part of, like, the Arkham games. Like, the same company made it. But it's not in the same style as the Batman Arkham game. So, it's just, like, I'll play it every once in a while, get on there. But, you know, I lost, anytime I buy a video game, after, like, 2 weeks maybe, I lose interest in it. Maybe I'll pick it up every once in a while, but, you know, it's just, eh. But the Fallout game, I've been putting a lot of hours in there. I think I'm like 24 hours, which honestly doesn't sound like a lot, But for me personally, that's a lot. You know, like I don't play video games. I'm not that person. I'd rather honestly study, focus my mind on something new, try something new, maybe make some videos or try a new technique with making videos, just research stuff, just because I want to learn how to do stuff and be active and just kind of wander the world, then wander a fake world with video games, you know? I think that's the best way for me to put it. I want to wander the real world, not wander a fake world. Every once in a while, sure, I'll have my moments where I, you know, probably just play video games for a little while, just kind of, you know, just forget about life for a little bit and switch things up. And that's probably what I was doing the last week. It's kind of like, all right, I've been on this growth mindset of like trying to like go and do stuff. And I think I just hit like a wall where I'm like, all right, let me slow down, play some video games, escape from the world. And that hasn't happened to me in a while. But I think it's things happening to me now. But I'm going to do my best to avoid that, because honestly, it's like I don't want to spend my time playing video games. Like, the TV show, like I said, it's a great show so far. Can't wait to see how it ends. I can't wait to, like, I heard there's a second season, like, in the works. So I'm excited for that, you know. If they come out with a new Fallout game, I will buy that one and play it until I get tired of it, which will, like I said, it's honestly going to be probably very quickly. Maybe not at first, but I'll get tired of it for sure. And the thing about Fallout, if you've never played it before, which is insane if you haven't started playing it, because like it's a huge like trend right now, is it's all about like mining, and like you have to collect a lot of stuff to do more stuff. So like even if you do glitches, you have to mine your glitch to get more quantity of the stuff that you need to progress in the game. And that's honestly just takes so much time, just to like even do the glitches takes time. And that's kind of what I've been doing. I've been trying to glitch the mining process. So instead of me having to go out and scavenger hunt all these items, I am just glitching it so I can have these items. But like at the same time, like it takes time. And the first time I played it, I glitched it in a sense that I just like, I forget what glitch I think I had. I think I was able to like, get any item from any person that was selling stuff, like armor, weapons, whatever. And I got like the best stuff, and I played the main story. Then I was done with it. I never played it again. But this time, I actually want to play the full game, go through the whole world, explore everything. But like I said, like I don't want to explore a fake world. I want to explore the real, this world that I'm living in, you know. But I'm gonna go inside, probably do some studying because I haven't read anything today. Maybe edit the video. I don't know. It's, I feel like my mind is just all over the place, but at the same time, it's like nowhere. You know, I kind of just want to sit out and just stare at the stars. I want to take a picture of the stars just kind of moving. Like, I want to go in the middle of nowhere and just kind of get a nice time lapse of the stars just moving around the world. Oh, excuse me. But that's like a bucket list for me. It's just, for some reason, like I like taking pictures. I like making videos. And I want to make like a cinematic video of my life. At least that's how I want to make my videos, is just kind of make it more like a movie. So many times there's like certain sequences that are just like, why is this here? It's like, I try to make it more like a movie. It's just like, if I get to the point of having kids, which I'm sure I will, or even my nephews, you know, when they grow up and they want to see what I've done, they're more entertained by watching it and seeing like a true story movie of myself. And just have like a actual historical documentation of my personal life, even if it's just for me, even if nobody watches it, just kind of like I want to be able to like watch myself and just see like what did I go through when I get old, you know, like what happened, and just kind of remember life as it was. Because once we get old, we probably forget a lot of things. And there's a lot of things that we don't want to forget, but we do. You know, we move on. And maybe I want to get to an age where I'm just like, damn, this used to be me. And just kind of glamorize the good old times I'm currently in right now when I'm old. Because, you know what, these are the good times. These are the best and the worst times to be in. You know, every day is a new world. You know, this is why I don't like sleeping in, because, like, there's just so much to do. Even though I don't do a lot of stuff, but I'm actively trying to learn how to do more stuff, which is what I like to do. I guess the best way to put it is to romanticize my life and just kind of, you know, make it into my own personal life documentation, a documentary, I guess, with my videos. Even though right now it's just all about fitness, I want to eventually kind of explore more outside of fitness. It's just the only thing that's stopping me is just like the people around me. They probably don't want to be on camera. I don't want to shove a camera in their face. But eventually I'm sure they'll get used to it. Like, you know, maybe you want to be on camera. Maybe they're just kind of like be a little like 5 second snippet of them in there eventually over time. But it's just like, I don't want to put them in there. Like, I might record something with them, but I won't post it. I might just have it stored away as like a memory file that I can someday look back at and just have it there. Because that's what I have with my family. Like, anything with my family, my nephew specifically, I have a certain file. And just store anything that I have with them away. And, you know, I'm sure when we all used to grow up, our parents used to take pictures of us as little kids and whatnot. And we probably don't even look at those pictures. I know I haven't, other than the ones that are hanging up. But I would like to make a video of my nephews or family or whatever, of just like, let's stick with them, and then just them growing up, for them to watch what they went through. So anytime I get a chance to hang out with them and put a camera in their face, it's for me to make memories with them and for them to look back at those memories at one point, you know, just to see how they used to be. Man, where did this energy come from? Sucks I didn't have this at the gym. All right, let's go inside. I gotta carry all this stuff in there.